Morning everyone, welcome back again with the same topic, that is solution. So we have already started with the colligative properties. Okay, three properties we have already discussed. Now the last one is left, that is osmotic pressure. Osmotic pressure. Fine. So before starting this topic, let's understand what is osmosis. Okay, what is osmosis? So as the name suggests, osmosis is derived from the word osmos, meaning to push something. Okay, so what is osmosis? This you have already like studied in the biology also. This is a part of topic of biology. So let's discuss its meaning in terms of chemistry. So to demonstrate the osmosis process, let's consider one experiment but demonstration. Let's take the beaker, okay, and place thistle funnel here. Okay, like this is the thistle funnel, and in the beaker water is there, and the thistle funnel will take the sugar solution or any salt solution, anything. Here we have taken water, and now the water and the sugar solution, they are separated by semi permeable membrane, that is SPM. So this is the SPM. Okay, SPM. Okay, semi permeable membrane. Okay, now what will happen after some time? After some time, we'll find that water level will start rising. Okay, in the sugar solution, it means movement of the water molecules is taking place from the pure water to the solution side, that is sugar solution, because there in sugar solution the water molecules are less because solute is also present, and here the only pure water molecules are present. So movement of the solvent molecules will take place from low from high concentration of solvent molecules to the low concentration, or you can say that from low concentration of solute molecules to the high concentration of the solute molecules, from a high water concentration to the low water concentration. Okay, and so let's see how this is happening. So say, let's say sugar solution level is still here. Okay, this is the initial level. Fine. So this is your thistle funnel. This is again SPM, water, sugar solution. This is your thistle funnel. Fine. Now the initially the level is still here. Now the level is this. So this is the final level. So to the up to this level, the water level has rises in the thistle funnel. This indicates that osmosis has taken place. Okay, here osmosis has taken place as rise in water level is observed in the funnel. Okay, so this demonstrates, this activity demonstrates osmosis, that is the movement of the solvent molecules from high water concentration to the low water concentration. Okay, this is osmosis. And why osmosis is taking place? Because osmosis is taking place due to the change, due to the difference in the vapor pressure of the solution and the solvent. As we have already studied difference in the vapor pressure, that is lowering in vapor pressure is taking place where any non-volatile solute is added to the solution. What is happening? There is a difference in the vapor pressure. Okay, because pure solvent is having its own vapor pressure. Fine, and solution is having its own vapor pressure. So accordingly, when the non-volatile solute is added to this, so there is a difference in the vapor pressure. To maintain that vapor pressure level or to maintain that equilibrium, okay, so water level of this water has two water molecules has to push to the that side where the low water concentration is there. Okay, so this is known as osmosis. And we have separated the two by the semi-permeable membrane. Now what's the use of SPM here? It's semi-permeable. It permeable means it allow only the selective materials to pass through it. Only the selective materials. And semi means partial. Okay, so semi-permeable membrane, it will allow only the solvent molecules to pass through here. It will not allow the solute molecules. Otherwise, the solute molecules will also come from the sugar side. Yes, so that will not happen. Okay, so only the solvent molecules will pass through the SPM. So this is the speciality, or you can say this is the characteristic feature of the semi-permeable membrane. Because SPM, if we talk about SPM, it is having sieves or pores. Okay, of small size. Small size, or you can say tiny nature. Very, very small. So that's why they only allow the solvent molecules to pass through it. So generally, like SPM, we can use of that animal origin, like SPM of animal origin, like pig bladder, pig or goat bladder. But this is not that much effective. So the SPM can be prepared in the laboratory. Okay, there is a synthetic ester. Synthetic or chemically, we can prepare the chemical SPM. So how we will prepare that? So let's understand that. How chemically we can prepare the SPM. Okay, chemically SPM can be prepared by treating copper sulfate with potassium ferrocyanide. Copper sulfate with potassium ferrocyanide, CuSO4, potassium ferrocyanide. This you will learn in the coordination compound. It's a coordination compound, actually complex one. Potassium ferrocyanide gives you copper ferrocyanide plus potassium sulfate. So this copper ferrocyanide gets filled into the pores of the porous membrane or pot in which the reaction has been taken place. So this will act as now SPM, semi-permeable membrane. This is a, we have prepared chemically. So this is the best, or you can say good or the effective SPM which is used to carry out the osmosis process. Fine. So how we will define osmosis? And osmosis also takes place between the two solutions having different concentrations. Although the solute is same, but the concentrations are different. So in that case, you can say it will move from the high solute concentration to the low solute concentration. Okay, and generally, you can say osmosis is defined, it's basically the movement of the solvent molecules. Okay, it is defined as the spontaneous movement of the solvent molecules from, it's a spontaneous movement of the solvent molecules either from the pure solvent into the solution or from the dilute solution to the concentrated solution. Either from the pure solvent, it depends what we have taken. Pure solvent into the solution or from the dilute solution to the concentrated solution, because dilute solution, solute molecules are less and water is molecules are more, that's why water molecules are moving. So basically it's the movement of the solvent molecules, okay, through SPM. Without semipermeable membrane, SPM osmosis will never takes place. Okay, osmosis will never takes place without semipermeable membrane. So this is about osmosis, and osmosis is taking place, again the basis is lowering in vapor pressure. Okay, osmosis taking place due to lowering in vapor pressure. This is the basis. Okay, let's take one more activity to demonstrate osmosis. It's very simple. What we have to do, you have to remove the outer layer of the eggshell. We know that eggshell is made up of what? Eggshell is made up of calcium carbonate. Okay, let's take two compartments. Okay, take in one compartment, take the water, and the another compartment take brine solution, NaCl solution. This is also known as brine solution. Here you have to place the egg. This is the egg here. Okay, and here also this is the egg. So when you will remove the outer layer of the that egg, and you just put in the HCl solution. Okay, outer layer of egg, put in HCl solution. After that you just put that egg in the water and one in the brine solution. So what you will observe, the egg which we have kept in the water, it will swell. So swelling is taking place. Swelling takes place. Here the egg which we have kept in NaCl solution, here shrinking of layer will takes place. Shrinkage takes place, and both are due to osmosis. Okay, so here swelling. So this you can say that here normal, dotted line represents change, and normal line represents size of the egg. Okay, this is a difference. So here it is swelling is taking place, because what is happening here? Why swelling? Because the water solvent molecules are moving from the pure water to the contained inside that layer. Here we have put in that sodium, this brine solution. So here the concentration is more, solute concentration. So that's why the water is coming out from that. Okay, so that's why shrinkage is taking place. So this is about the osmosis. I hope it's clear to everyone what is osmosis. Now it will be easier for you to understand the concept of osmotic pressure. Okay, so we'll start the osmotic pressure in the next class. Till then, thank you and have a nice day.